today. Now, the first one is a follow-on from last week. It created quite a lot of comment. I had calls coming from auctioneers from all over the place from last week's comment. Because we talked about, and those of you who didn't see last week, but I know some of you are sitting there, and hello to my friends in Dubbo who I know sit around and watch in the afternoons. Now, let me tell you about what we talked about last week was using the auction reserve after a property had been passed in, and the agent then using that as a negotiating tool. As I said, many auctioneers called in and let me know that not only that is happening, but it's when agents are choosing to tell prospective purchasers, so bidders, registered bidders, they'll sidle up next to a bidder during the auction. So it hasn't been passed in, the auction is still happening, the auction is live, it's going there. The auctioneer is talking their spiel up there out at the front, and they're trying to get every bid that they possibly can. And the agents are out in within the audience, and they are sidling up next to a prospective purchaser and saying, guys, here, look, have a look at this. Showing them the paper and saying, here's the reserve, we're not far off. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Good process, bad process. You can use it, but there's a couple of conditions here. So if you are going to go down the path and do that process, one, you need to make sure that every registered bidder is getting the same opportunity. So let's be fair and equitable about this, making sure that you are not just giving this advantage to one of the registered bidders. The other one, of course, is what we said last week, is absolutely have that discussion with your vendor prior to the auction actually commencing, and get their approval to use this sales technique if and when it is needed throughout the process, making it very clear to your vendor that you'll be talking to every registered bidder to let them know that throughout the process. Because one, you've got to be fair and equitable. Remember, there's a code of conduct, which is Schedule 1 of the regulations that you need to adhere to. And secondly, you need to be acting upon the advice of the instructions of your vendor. So guys, make sure you get both sides of that correct. So it was interesting how many people rang in and said agents are using that process. Look, I've been to an auction, and most of you who know me know I'm a prize sticky beak, love going to auctions and watching what's going on, love watching auctioneers and their techniques. It's one of the fun parts of our industry and one of the exciting parts of our industry. And I've seen an auctioneer stand up and say the reserve is set at. And so he said, and that's where the bidding started. And I thought, oh, wow. Actually asked the auctioneer after that auction, did they have approval from the vendor? Absolutely was the answer. And the vendor heard me actually ask the auctioneer the question, said, oh, yeah, we talked about this as a technique. As you know, if that's the reserve, that's where we want to go. So if that was the only bid we got, then it was over and done and less stress. So look, there's lots of techniques you can use, but remember, talk to your vendor, make sure it's fair and equitable that you're offering the same strategies to each and every one of your consumers, and then go with whatever is going to work and be legal down that path. So guys, that was just an update on when you use the auction reserve as a point of negotiation. So good luck with those of you who are selling or attempting to sell properties via auction.